Hallo, mein Name ist Henning
Riesele. Hi, my name is Henning Riesele. I'm head of design of Studio FA Porsche in Berlin. Studio FA Porsche is a design agency for solutions in the premium design segment. We take care of our own brand, Porsche Design, but we are also an agency, a design agency for customers worldwide in consumer electronics, household devices, investment goods and also mobility.
In unserer Designphilosophie folgen wir unserem Gründer.
Our design philosophy follows in the footsteps of Ferdinand Alexander Porsche.
In seiner Zeit,
he, in his time,
Designphilosophie aufgestellt, die sich begründet.
Defined our design strategy. He wanted to find extraordinary solutions for his customers. And we try to live up to that even today. Our solutions are functional, but also puristic. So we design long-lived, high-quality products for our customers.
Ich habe keinen Klicker. Sorry.
There seems to be a technical issue. Sorry.
Ich bin Moritz Papenfuß, verantwortlich.
My name is Moritz Papenfuß. I am in charge of design at MHP. Design has different levels: applied, strategic, design, transformation, organization development.
Volkswagen-Konzern natürlich da.
We have design consulting for Volkswagen. We also advise our customers from production.
In den Sektoren zum Beispiel
also in the energy sector, in the financial sector, in the context of mobility. Our goal is to find explorative solutions and to review these systemic effects. What does it mean if we make that decision, for example? For us, it is also important to design workplaces. And I'm not referring to the chair. I'm referring to our way of cooperation that is increasingly digital.
Als Produktdesigner sind wir immer mehr konfrontiert.
As product designer, we get ever more confronted with our customers' wishes for the integration of new technology, larger screens, the latest touchscreen technology, voice input, huge screens on fridges, for example. Nobody will ever sit in front of a fridge watching a movie.
Irgendwie ja dort in Sachen navigieren, die er sonst auf
navigating through things that they would otherwise do on their smartphones. So the question is, does this technology make sense? Is it used in a sensible way? And what's more, in product development,
während der Entwicklungszeit technische
during the development phase there are technical limitations, cost pressure.
Komponenten genommen werden,
which leads to components being used that would that do not live up to these expectations. So the user might become frustrated in the end because the user experience is not given. So for us as designers, we have to ask ourselves, does it make sense, the integration of all the components? Does design really have to focus so much on that if it doesn't even make the product better? The question is, always about the customer experience after having bought a product. Is the customer happy if they bring home the product and they don't have that customer experience? I also think it's important that arbitrary individual solutions do not prevail. This might lead to time cost pressure.
In enterprise applications sieht man dann häufig
in enterprise applications you find for example a time that is shown again although there is the system time. The weather is another example.
Notifications die anfangen.
There are also notifications
zu unterbrechen,
that are disrupting, that are interfering. Everything includes a little bit of Bluetooth, even a toothbrush. It has Bluetooth functions.
Digital nicht als Add-on verstehen.
So digital mustn't be an add-on. It must be a sustainable added value, good digital products. digital is dangerous because everything is possible. And I think we should be careful and we should be very mindful of the attention of all those who are using the product later. This brings me to the title of today's talk, Good Design is Holistic. This refers to Dieter Rams, who defined the 10 rules of good design. In his time as head designer for Braun, these rules were very proactive because Dieter Rams didn't only consider the aesthetic design, but also the meaningfulness of design. The customer was in the focus. The longevity of the products played a role. And today that is even more important because we've got the digital level, something that he couldn't foresee in his time. And now the question is, how do we have to comprehend good digital design? So this holistic approach is important. There is not the physical and the digital level, but it needs to be a unified approach. And Dieter Rams also said less, do less, but better. He doesn't say less is more, he says less is less, but better. So you need to design the right thing.
Gutes Design ist ehrlich.
In the right way.
Klingt wie ein Zitat von
Good design is honest. It sounds like Dieter Rams, but it's actually by our founder, Ferdinand Alexander Porsche. Honesty refers to the honesty towards the user, but also towards the customer, the development, and it is important that there is a holistic product experience. Good design is also responsible for the user, for the customer, the end customer,
for the
environment and the society.
Und damit kommen wir zu unserer Verbindung.
And this brings us to the link MHP and FI Porsche. We think that this holistic approach is very important and we follow it in our projects. I'll show you an example of a manufacturer of high-end audio equipment. Here's the first picture.
Eigentlich typisch wie immer, wir kriegen einen Auftrag.
This started as always. We get an assignment, the customer approached us, wishing for the next generation of equipment. And we very quickly got to the point where we thought, this cannot only be hardware, this also requires Moritz and his team, because the hardware experience is only part of the solution.
Wir hatten dabei die Vision des Gründers.
So the vision of the founder was the listener can close their eyes, listen to the music and is disturbed by nothing. And we use that vision to control our concepts and our plans. This is our main filter that we need to apply so that the vision is transformed into the product. And here you see the design. On the left-hand side you see the hardware. Product
und für die
in this world of experience and for the hardware, of course, the listening to the music was the focus and not the operation of the device. So following the guideline we've just heard, listening to music is the core message of that product, which is why the design of this hardware is very simple, high quality material on a solid basis. So the product design corresponds to the music quality that the user is listening to. So the design language is really reduced. The product is not to become a competitor of the music. It is rather an equal partner. We've got three user scenarios. On the left-hand side, the user using the device. Then we've got the remote control. So the user can listen to the music on the couch or in the kitchen.
Weiter auswählen kann. Wichtig war uns dabei ein haptisches
Erlebnis. Here it was important that we have a consistent feel of the remote control.
Hier ist es eigentlich spannend zu sehen,
the exciting thing here is that we focused on a knob. for the product. The knob is not a new element, it is a very traditional element. You can use it intuitively, everybody knows a knob, everybody knows how to adjust the volume with a knob. So it's very intuitive, very reduced, but due to the high quality material, it also has a good look and feel. So this knob has an electronic component. Whenever you turn the knob, you feel a slight vibration when you adjust the volume, which is important because there is a second level. When you choose the music source, and you choose the source by using the knob as well, but the distances, the intervals are different. So here the combination between digitality and analogous feedback is given.
Im Inneren dieses Drehreglers haben
Within that knob, we've got a touchscreen. The touchscreen is extremely reduced. It has a black and white screen because we don't want to distract the user from the music. The remote control and the device have the same knob and have the same intuitive operation. It's not about generating playlists and so forth.
Hier geht es darum, schnell
it is really about
die Lautstärke zu regeln,
starting the music quickly, adjusting the volume, maybe choosing the next title on the device, but also via remote control. You don't want to have to go to through menus or scroll through things.
Ist, dass wir halt diesen Screen in den Drehregler.
The screen is included in the knob, so we explicitly did not want to have a mobile phone display that would invite you to somehow deal with the music or look into the music options. It's about enjoying the music. So, the application. We focus on the music as well. It's just the same Leitmotif. Intuition, haptics, materiality. But here you can choose different albums.
Add-ons, die in
However, we don't have add-ons that you might be used from apps like Songtext, Karaoke, or video snippets that are repeating in the background. Visual reduction is key. Calmness is key to have the full music experience. We only have what we need for that experience. Here we don't have a knob, here we have a slider, because we said we want to have that app as intuitive as possible, learned patterns, and when it comes to adjusting volume on the digital level, we are all used to a slider.
Ich habe an der Stelle die Möglichkeit, haptisches Feedback.
So here you can also get haptic feedback via the smartphone. We call it digital material. The product needs to have a good feel. So here you can see the knob has a chrome ring that changes depending on how you hold your smartphone. Not many people realize it. Some only realize it after a week. But the users realize that we really spend a long time thinking about the small details. Design is discreet. It is not bold. So we have now explained the hardware and the digital level to show you this perfect combination and cooperation between our two companies, which can only be achieved if everything is based on a very holistic approach to product development, and it is important to link product designers and digital designers and to make decisions together. This means that we do not hand over or transfer any components. we take a look at everything together and take the decisions together, because the decisions we take have certain effects, and we want to guarantee that consistency between the physical and the digital world.
Yeah. Und damit kommen wir eigentlich zu der Zusammenfassung.
And this brings us to our summary of today. What are the core parts of our cooperation? What makes us stand out from competition?
Muss man nennen, dass wir eine Haltung haben und einen couragierten Design.
So we have
das bedeutet,
a bold attitude, a bold approach to design. We do not simply accept what the customer says. We bring in our own opinion and we consult our customers. Hence, we assume responsibility, which is very, very important, because we are responsible towards the customer and the end user. Another aspect of our cooperation is that we actively shape the future. We don't want to follow trends, or we don't want to follow up on what's currently available on the market. We want to think proactively. We want to deliver future-proof solutions with viable technologies. Hence, we are generating a long-term relevance for our customers. Relevance?
Kunden- und Nutzererlebnisse relevant.
For whom are we relevant? For our customers, for our user experience. We are relevant for the product development process. What's the background? What's the processes that stand behind all this? How do we work together? How are these products developed? How do we set up the organizations? What do the services in the background look like whenever we set up a workplace to develop a good digital product? So we are also shaping an employee experience. All of this helps to develop good design. We hope that this gave you some food for thought for your products, projects and processes. Thank you for your attention.